Cruelty forced a cat to take extreme measures just to survive. She ended up in good hands, though, and now she's learning about the good that can come from human hands. News 4's Mike McCormick with the Feline's Lifeline.
You can hear the growls of gratitude coming from behind the walls of the Asheville Humane Society.
We're the safety net for all the homeless and abandoned animals in our community.
They're also a lifeline. 3-year-old Noelle is living proof.
Noelle is just one of 4,000 lives that we save on an annual basis.
Animal Control brought her here days before Christmas, and the staff here turned out to be as much of a gift to her as she was to them.
She's a very special girl.
Before her rescue, she'd been wandering around a trailer park. These photos show how she looked then.
She was almost like a skeleton underneath all of her fur.
Starving, covered in fleas, missing teeth, weak, and coping with an infection caused by Cruelty.
Somebody purposely tied a shoestring around her front leg. Obviously, that had cut off the circulation and her leg began to die. And we believe she may have had to self-amputate in order to stay alive.
Once she was here, she got a lot of love, food, and medical attention. 10 days ago, donations paid for a generous doctor to finish the life-saving job she tried to do herself.
And I just want to thank the community for stepping forward and helping us give this little girl the second chance that she deserves.
Catherine Chenard, the president of the Asheville Humane Society, is now Noelle's foster mom, but in a few weeks, she'll be ready for adoption.
Animals like Noelle steal our heart and make us work even harder for the next animal that's going to come our way that needs this special attention.
Of course, to keep offering those life-saving services, the Asheville Humane Society does need some donations. If you'd like to help them out, or you'd like to learn more about Noelle, or maybe even look into adopting her, just look in the Scene on 4 section of WIFF4.com. Mike McCormick, WIFF News 4 in Asheville.